about dynamics. Previously, we discussed about robo kinematics, kinematics of two types, forward kinematics and reverse kinematics. We obtained the kinematics equation by two methods. One is algebraic approach, other one is geometric approach. After that, we discussed the robo dynamics. What is dynamics? Dynamics is the science which deals with the motion along with their derivatives, say displacement, acceleration, velocity, and so on. Okay. Then we discussed the type of, during dynamics study, we modeled the dynamic model of a 2 degree of freedom robot, okay, particularly RR robot, both joints are rotary. Also, let's see, just to go back with our discussion. So this is the 2 degree of freedom robo. So RR robo, two joints are, it's a RR robo. So we modeled the RR robo using the kinematics equations by finding the kinetic energy and potential energy of the robo joints and links. Okay. Then we found the modeling equation using Lagrange's solution. So Lagrange's equation. Okay. L equal to kinematic minus potential energy. So to formulate the dynamic model of this robo, we found the kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is 1/2 mv square. So for each joint, we calculated using the forward kinematic equation. This actually, the x1 equal to L1 sin theta, x2, y1 equal to L1 cos theta. These two are the forward kinematics of this RR robo. Then using that x1, y1, we found the velocity after finding the velocity, dx by dt is the velocity, x is the displacement. Okay, this is the displacement. So this is velocity. This is velocity. So after finding x1 dot and y1 dot, the resultant velocity v1 equal to x1 dot square, x y1 dot square. Okay. So finally, after substituting here, we found that the velocity of the link 1 is link length into the angular velocity of the first joint. Then similarly, similar to that, we found the displacement. We are using forward kinematic equation for joint two. So from the figure, x2 equal to L2 sin theta 1 plus theta 2, L1 equal to sin theta 1. So similarly, y2 equal to L minus L1 cos theta 1 minus L2 cos theta of theta 1 plus theta. So after differentiating this, we get velocity. Velocity on the x direction, velocity on y direction. So finally, we found v2 square, that is v2 square equal to x2 dot square and y2 dot square. X2 dot square plus y2 dot square. So after substituting the values, we found the velocity of the second joint. So the velocity of the second joint is this one, right? So we substituted the values of k1 and k2 and K1 equal to of M1 L1. This is the V1 value. Similarly, we substituted V2 value. After finding this, the total kinetic energy equal to K1 plus K2. Now, after finding kinetic energy, we have to find potential energy. That also we found in the last class itself. The potential energy of the joint one is H is minus L1 cos theta 1. So that after adding this, the total potential energy equal to P1 plus P2. So Lagrangian suggested the relation equal to L equal to kinetic energy minus potential energy. So we considering the relation. So considering the relation, let X equal to function of each joint parameters. Joint parameters nothing but Q1, Q2, Q3, Qi, and their time. Okay, so time under the joint parameters. So if you, the kinetic energy is of mv square, v is x dot, so substituted. So we found dou k by dou q dot, that also we found. After deriving this relation, we defined the function q equal to d by dt of dou q by dou q dot minus dou k by dou q. Okay, so we substituted dou k by dou q dot from the relation from this relation we substituted there. So q equal to, we substituted this values here. Finally, we obtained q equal to f, force f equal dou x by dou q equal to dou by d by dt of dou k by dou q minus dou q dot minus dou q by sorry dou k by dou q. So we substituted the q, we altered the q expression, this q expression here as a ql. So as ql d by dt of, instead of k we substitute dou l by dou q dot minus dou l by dou q. So we substitute L. If we differentiate this, dou L by dou Q dot equal to dou K by this we obtained. Finally, the dynamic equation for generalized, actually the dynamic equation for the RR robo is QL equal to D by DT of dou L by dou Q dot minus dou L by dou Q. This is the dynamic equation for double R robo. If there are n number of links, n number of joints, Q1, Q2, Q3, etc., then the equation is generalized as QLi. So we added I here. So QLi equal to d by dt of dou Li by dou dot qi minus dou li by dou q dot i. So what is L? Li is Lagrange's equation. Okay, Lagrangian equation for i joints. So using this relation, we can formulate the dynamic model for any number of joint robots, any degree of freedom robot. So the mathematical modeling of any degree of freedom manipulator is we have to follow these steps. So derivation of robot dynamics model using Lagrange's equation. This is very important. So first point is choose the generalized coordinates like x, y, along with the q1, q2, q3, etc. And you can also use DHC parameters for the relation. Okay, then identify the non-conservative forces that are exerted by the system, that is tau. This the the generalized coordinates are theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, etc. Theta 3, etc. Q, that is Q values. Q is the joint parameters. Identify the non-conservative forces tau 1, tau 2, tau 3, etc. Then calculate the kinetic energy and potential energy using the relation of mv square and P equal to mgh. So after that, after finding kinetic energy and potential energy, you can find the Lagrangian solution, L equal to K minus P. Substitute the value of kinetic energy K minus, substitute the value of potential energy, whatever we found for the particular manipulator here. So calculate the partial derivatives. Partial derivatives, what are the partial derivatives? You see, dou L by dou Q dot. Dou L by dou Q. We have to find the partial derivatives. That is, first we have to find, say, dou L by dou Q 1 dot. Similarly, dou L by dou Q 1. So if you found this value, you can substitute, simply substitute d by dt of dou L by minus this. So this is the dynamic modeling equation. See, this is the equation for QL, dynamic model equation, d by dt of dou L by dou Q dot minus dou L by dou Q. So L is nothing but Lagrangian equation. What is Lagrangian? Kinetic energy minus potential energy. That's using that value only we calculated here. See, dk by dou k by dou q dot, because potential energy is zero here, so dou q dot we obtain this. So after finding dk by d by dt of dou k by dou q dot, we've got the solution for double R rule. So after calculating kinetic energy and potential energy, then we found L equal to kinetic energy minus potential energy. Calculate the partial derivatives, these partial derivatives for each joints. Then calculate the generalized force. So generalized force, what are the force acting on the manipulators? Then apply Lagrange's equation. You have to apply the in the Lagrange's equation. We followed the steps. We did the two robo, same thing we applied here. Whatever procedure I explained now is applicable to 2 degree of freedom robo. So first joint kinetic energy and the second joint kinetic energy, we calculated everything. Then after finding kinetic energy and potential energy, we have to find L equal to K minus P. So then find dou L by dou theta 1, dou L by dou theta 2. This is the step 5. Find partial derivatives. Find the partial derivatives. Okay. Partial derivatives. So after finding dou L by dou theta 1, dou L by dou theta 2, this is the generalized force coordinate using work done, force coordinates. So that is nothing but tau 1. This is the tau 1 and tau 2, sine theta 1, sine theta 1, tau 2, sine theta 2. So force, generalized force equal to tau 1 by tau 1 and tau 2. This is the matrix. So matrix tau 1 and tau 2. So then apply Lagrange's equation. That QL equal to dou Q by dou Q dot 1. Here, that is equal to this. Okay. So by using this, after applying the Lagrange's equation, I asked you to find dou L by dou theta 1, dou L by dou theta 2, and I asked you to find the dynamic model for this robo. Okay. So what is the dynamic model for this 2 degree of freedom robo? I asked. Have you found that? Hello, anybody? Have you followed these steps and find any solution? Nobody. Hello. Hello. I found the dynamic model of 2 degree of freedom, Robo. Dynamic model of 2 degree of freedom, Robo, is M2 L1 square plus 0.25 M2 L2 square plus L cos theta 2 plus M2 L2 this is L cos theta 2 M2 L M2L cos L2 cos theta 2. Okay. 0.25 second row first element. 0.25 M2. L2 square. Plus 0.5 M2 L1 L2 cos theta 2. Okay. Second row is 0.25 M2 L2 square plus L cos theta 2 plus 0.5 M2 L1 L2 cos theta 2 0.25 M2 L2 square plus L cos theta 2 into here theta 1. So this matrix into theta 1 double dot by theta 2 double dot. Okay. So this model, this matrix mentioned as H of Q into theta double dot. So theta 1 double dot, theta 2 double dot, this should be here. Then plus minus M2 L1 L2 sine theta 2 of theta 1 dot plus 0.5 theta 2 theta 2 dot. Theta 2 dot. Then 0.5 m2 l1 l2 sin theta 2 theta 1 dot square. Okay. Plus point 5 m1 point 5 m1 plus m2 l1 g cos theta 1 plus 0.5 m2 l2 g cos theta 2 0.5 m2 l2 g cos of theta 1 plus theta 2. Here also I missed one thing, cos theta 1 plus theta 2. Cos of theta 1 plus theta 2. Okay. So this together equal to tau 1 tau. So this is represented as C of Q dot comma Q dot. This matrix represented as G of Q. So the generalized form of the equation is H of Q is the symmetric matrix. So the C of Q comma Q dot is the centralized and the Coriolis forces. Centralized and the Coriolis forces. So the generalized relation. The generalized relation for the robodynamic model is H of Q theta double dot plus C of Q Q dot. Okay. C of Q Q dot plus G of Q equal to F equal to F. So what is F? This F equal to tau 1 tau 2. So this is force coordinate. So this is the dynamic model of it. 2 degree of freedom robo. This is very, very important. So assignment plus first test mark will be awarded for this. Please note down this. Develop the dynamic model of triple R robo. The assignment is, you have to submit in PDF format. Assignment, dynamic model of triple R robo. Triple R robo. Clear? So far we discussed this thing. So just I recall the equations. Next is we did the motion path planning of a robo. So there are different type of path planning. A slow motion. What is for path planning? From moving from one place to another place. Okay. If the robo has say a particular position, suppose robo is here, say consider same 2 degree of freedom robo. So this initially at a theta 1 value, so at theta 2 value. So this is the initial position PI. If you want to move the end effector, the end position of the robo from P1 to P2, say this is the another place, P2, or anywhere in the space, P3. So if you want to move from P1 to P initial to P final, so what are the path direction it will follow? So the robo follows which path? And the robo or dynamics, the motion, the motor attached at the joints. So it has, the motor has its own velocity profile and acceleration profile. So what is slow motion? So slow motion is all joints start simultaneously. Each joint takes its own time. Okay, each joint takes its own time. So that is called a slow motion. So let's see what are the different type of motion, slow motion and joint interpolated motion. Actually, these comes in the controller programming. So if you develop a robo and if you want to write the robo programming, we require the type of motion, slow motion, joint interpolated motion, and straight line or continuous path motion. Okay. So the, in general, we also did some problem, what is the time required to reach the final position using slow motion, what is the total travel time we calculated. This is the profile for angle and the velocity profile. This velocity profile I already mentioned, this profile is followed in the railway traction control. So from one place to when a train, electric train or any other mode of train moves from one place to another place, initially acceleration is going on, then it reaches the maximum steady position, then for when the next station comes, they will apply deceleration so that it will reduce the speed and settle at the next station exactly. So this is the traction control. Same velocity profile is following in the slow motion. Okay, so we calculated this t acceleration, deceleration and everything. In general, the slow motion means the time total time taken equal to di by velocity, distance by velocity. So you see here the initial distance by velocity. So time equal to distance by velocity. So the d acceleration deceleration we calculated, angular position and final position also calculated. Okay. So the trajectory will pursue. The slow motion, we consider this is the generalized time equation for slow motion, what is the time maximum, which joint takes maximum time, so that time is applicable. See here, in this system, I'll see here, the maximum time is 3.6, right? T max 1.6, 0.467 second. So the robo takes 3.6 seconds to reach its final position. Okay. So this is the total time, acceleration, deceleration. So the maximum time is 4.4. 4.4 second is the maximum time to reach from initial position to final position. So the slow motion time taken equal to maximum of di by vi, velocity. So this will be the maximum time taken. Next is joint interpolated motion. So what is joint interpolated motion? The characteristics of all joints, okay, that require the angular movement to start simultaneously and stop simultaneously. Okay, whereas in the slow motion, each joint starts may simultaneously, but settle at different times. Okay, whereas this joint replicant motion, all the joints start simultaneously and settle at simultaneously. Each at simultaneously. So the robot will attempt to achieve the simultaneous start and stop by getting the speed of motion along the axis proportional to the distance to be traveled. Okay, so the in this case, a joint interpolated motion so start and stop simultaneously. Start and stop simultaneously. Okay, so in this, according to this, Ti equal to constant. So the total time is constant. Total time is constant. So that is equal to this. That is proportional to distance by velocity. Okay. And di by vi, sorry, di by d capital di equal to constant. The proportionality, also constant, and the joints maintain linear proportionality in the joint interpolated motion. That is the reason is also called linear joint interpolated motion. So this is also called, since it is proportional, this is also called linear joint interpolated motion. The trajectory will be smooth in Cartesian coordinates. The joint, this can be in Cartesian coordinates, this can be expressed as, instead of I, di by dx, x direction, right? In the x direction, Cartesian means three directions. Dx by da, capital dx, equal to dy by capital dy, dz by dz. So this is I in different directions. So x direction and y direction and z direction. So this relationship indicates an approximate linear velocity, linear motion in the other configuration. Resultant path will not be linear, but this joint interpolated motion generates the smooth movements, because if in this way the tear and wear effect of the joint is reduced. In joint interpolated motion, the controller first identifies the displacement along each axis. The controller identify the displacement of each axis and find the axis that require maximum travel time at the default speed. So that axis will use its default speed. So which axis will take more time? So the speed in other axis be slower than the default speed using this relationship. So the default speed for the joint interpolated motion using this time. So time relation is, this will be maximum of Ti, that is maximum of distance by velocity. So when we program to move the robo manipulator, first the controller, our design controller, should identify the distance, each distance, how much distance the robo manipulator should move to x direction, y direction, z direction, etc. So it will identify the maximum time using this relation, distance by velocity. Then that maximum displacement time is taken as the default time. So the lesser distance, the lesser time required, other joints will slowly move, whereas the long distance robo will move the default speed. Other joints will move slowly so that the initial and the final motions are same. That means the start and stop done simultaneously, right? Next is let's see one small problem. The actually this type of motion. The important applications of joint interpolated motion. This is theory. Application. Joint interpolated motion. Okay, first one is it has smooth motion. Smooth path profile. Smooth motion. Motion and the path profile. Path, okay, path profile. So there won't be any wear effect at the joint. Okay, joint. For example, gear mechanisms, motors. So we can avoid wear and tear effect. Next is control is much simpler. Control is simple or simpler than other profiles, other type of motion. Okay. The next is robo can move start and stop simultaneously to end singularity free. Okay, so start and stop simultaneously. So the application is, main application is pick and place robo and spot welding applications. Okay. Next is continuous path control. Continuous path control. So actually, this path control requires a project trajectory, or path trajectory. So it requires the path trajectory. Several joints can move simultaneously in some user specified time. Okay, so basically can move simultaneously by the user specified or defined trajectory path profile. So you can take it in path profile or trajectory. Path trajectory. Okay. A common way to achieve the continuous path control is using the via intermediate points, various intermediate points. So the way to achieve the motion, common way to achieve motion using many intermediate points, Let's see some examples also. Suppose if you want to move from one place to another place, it will take the intermediate points. So these intermediate points will be defined by the user, robotic application or a maker. Okay. So the from position X1 to X2, if the robo end effector move from X1 to X2, here is E2, end effector 2, end effector 1. From when we want to move from this place to this place, so the user or the control programmer will define intermediate points with some path profile. Say in our case, I am going to use quadratic as well as the third order polynomial. So if you use say for example, if you use y equal to mx, so what is the profile y equal to mx? It is the linear profile. So the intermediate points will lie on the linear axis. Clear? Say if I use y square equal to 4x. So what is the profile? The profile is a parabolic. So from one end to another end, from this end to this end, the programmer will find the fix the intermediate points in the profile. So similarly, if you say y equal to ax square plus bx plus c, so what is the path profile? The quadratic profile. Similarly, you can use y equal to ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. So this is the third order polynomial equation. So if you follow a particular specified path profile or trajectory to make a motion, then this type of program called continuous path control program. So the controller will attempt to follow a path by many via points. The controller will attempt to pass the point and maintain the speed according to the intermediate point positions. Okay, different vendor, the different ways to specify the allowable distances. For example, Allen Bradley robots, user specify the robo of the sphere around the point. Controller will ensure that error at the via point is not larger than the radius. Suppose the sphere around a point, okay? So radius of the sphere. So the Allen Bradley controller specified the via points is lesser than the radius of the sphere, okay? So this is about the continuous path control. Let's see small example. Take down find a smooth path for a robo robo joint that will turn from theta equal to 75 degree to theta equal to minus 35 degree in 10 seconds. Do this by developing an equation, then calculating points at every 1 second along the path for a total motion time of total motion time of 10 seconds. So how to develop this? Please do it. What is the solution? So what is given? So given theta is zero. Okay, our initial position theta I. Can take as theta I or theta zero. Theta zero means t equal to zero. Okay, theta zero is 75 degree. So time is 0 seconds. So theta final 10 seconds. Okay, is minus 35 degree. So t equal to 10 seconds. So we can use the path profile of third order polynomial for smooth. Okay, to smooth, we're having a third order polynomial.